In this video, we focus on animation as well as the animation editors in Autodesk Smoke. To follow along, you can download the media by clicking the link in the YouTube description. Or if you're watching the podcast version of this video, you can type the link displayed in your internet browser. The first thing you need to know about animation is that you can create animation in two modes. The first mode is using AutoKey that automatically animates the affected values as you work. As long as AutoKey is on, keyframes are placed in the sliders with any adjustments. The second mode is working with AutoKey set to off. You have to manually set keyframes to animate a value. Simply set your value and hold the K keyboard shortcut and click the slider. This sets a keyframe in this animation channel on this specific frame. You can also right-click on the slider box to access a wealth of keyframing commands. So I'll reset this channel to its default value. You can also hold Option Command and click the slider to reset the channel completely. When it comes to adjusting values, drag the slider to the left or right. The slider's adjustment changes at a medium pace. Pressing Option Q and dragging the slider causes the values to change very slowly. This is great for fine adjustments. And holding down Option W and dragging the slider adjusts the value very fast for larger values. However, for precise adjustments, you click the slider. In the pop-up calculator, you can set the exact values. Let's try some of this with our animation example. We'll use AutoKey to create a basic animation. On the first frame, I'll position the graphic to the left. On the last frame, I'll position the graphic to the right. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see that this has automatically created animation between the two keyframes. It is important to know that once there is an animation in a channel and you are not using AutoKey, any adjustments will be ignored unless you do one of two things. You could turn AutoKey back on and make your adjustment. Or make your adjustment, hold K and click on the slider to add a new keyframe or adjust an existing one. So you can choose whether to keep AutoKey on or off when working with animation channels. If you wanted to reset a channel without going into the animation editor, you can right-click on the slider and choose a reset option. Here you have two choices. You can reset to the original default value, or you can reset the animation channel to the current value of the slider at this frame with no additional animation in the channel. Just focusing on the sliders for the moment, there are indicators to tell you the state of the parameter at the current frame. A simple number in the slider tells you that the channel is at its default state. An asterisk in the slider tells you that the value has been changed from its original value. With regards to animation, a yellow line under the value tells you that there is an animation keyframe at this frame. The blue line under the value indicates that this slider is an animated channel, but you are not on a keyframe at this frame. This means you do not always have to go searching through the animation channel editor when looking to find which channel has an animated keyframe. Holding Shift and clicking on a slider selects it. This also shows the particular animation keyframes in the time bar. This allows you to navigate those keyframes with the navigation controls. The shortcuts are assigned to Option K and Shift K on your keyboard. So the time bar will only show the selected channel's keyframes. Either shift-click a slider to select it, or hold Command and click on a slider to add it to the selection. All the selected channel keyframes will now be shown in the time bar. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.